هيا على الفلاح.
Verse number 19, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues. And remember, these verses came down one after the other. All have the same reason of revelation. It was the incident of the accusation of Aisha radiallahu anha. So Allah says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُحِبُّونَ أَن تَشِيعَ الْفَاحِشَةُ فِي الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ والله يعلم وأنتم لا تعلمون. Indeed, those who love to spread immorality among the believers and those who love to spread stories of immorality among the believers shall face a severe punishment in this world and the next. For indeed, Allah knows and you do not know. What does this mean? Stories of immorality. You have a tale. True or false is besides the point. But we are believers. You see something that is immoral, something regarding adultery, fornication, nudity, something regarding immodesty. It is not the quality of a believer to spread that tale. It is not the quality of the believer to tell everyone else. Today, let's face facts. A lot of us are guilty. A lot of us are guilty of passing around dirty jokes, dirty, immoral, what we would term below the belt jokes. And we think it's just a laugh. You don't realize you're a true believer. It's not a true believer's quality to forward such jokes, to forward such video clips, to forward such messages. It's become so easy to mess ourselves. And I'm using this term because literally we become people who are clogged with that which is unacceptable. Where then will we have space for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You know, your brain has a capacity. Say for example, terabytes, gigabytes, whatever you want to say. The more you pack it up with images, with videos, and remember, videos take up a lot of space. You know that. Images take up a lot of space. They occupy your mind. Your processing speed becomes slow. You come in salah, Allahu Akbar. Before you realize you're in salah, it's already Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Why? Because your mind is filled with pornography, dirty stories, bad tales. Things that are true, things that are false about people. What do you have to do with how the other person committed adultery? This is why sometimes it becomes dangerous to read these stories even in the media. We don't need to know the detail of how someone raped another person, how someone committed adultery with another person. All it does is it contaminates the mind. And this is why as mu'mineen we believe it is not befitting for us even to relate to others how the robber has stolen, because sometimes the weak-minded will use that as a learning procedure in order to know how to steal. All I had to do was to read the Sunday Times. It gives me the details of how the bank robbery happened. Now I just need to scratch my head and say, right, I know what to do. May Allah forgive us. If this is the case, then obviously we as believers should understand, keep your mind fresh. Keep it empty of these type of stories. Ask Allah's forgiveness. Keep it filled with beautiful stories of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum. Stories of goodness, stories of piety, stories of loving people, stories of how people solve problems, how they repented to Allah rather than stories of sin. Look at what Allah says. Those who love to spread such stories amongst the believers, for them will be a severe punishment in this world and then the next. What did I say moments ago? Our lives are being turned upside down. We are struggling and suffering. We have everything material, but we don't have contentment. Perhaps it's because we are engaging in some of these deeds and we don't even realize. May Allah forgive us. My brothers and sisters, reality check. This beautiful eve of the month of Ramadan, a few nights remaining. Do you believe we just commenced the other day and we are already almost at the end of Ramadan? Subhanallah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to open our doors and to grant us goodness. And we ask Allah to help us not to relate tales that are full of immorality. My brothers and sisters, I plead with you to think very carefully before you forward anything that someone has sent you on your mobile phone, be it on WhatsApp, on Twitter, on Facebook, on any other platform you have. Think very, very hard. Will this message help you in the relation that you have with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or not? If it's going to help you and assist you, forward it. If not, the best help you would be able to achieve is to delete it for the sake of Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strengthen us. Go back to your phones this evening and check in the phone images that are unacceptable, messages unacceptable, videos unacceptable. Find it in your heart to delete it. it would be one of the biggest acts of worship for Laylatul Qadr that you could engage in, besides those that are taught by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because we are cleaning ourselves, we are cleansing the history, we are taking things out, and we won't accept that again. Someone sends you a message, tell them, not me. Do you have the guts to do that for the sake of Allah? Or are you just going to have a laugh and say, no, okay, let's all have a laugh? My brothers and sisters, that's the contamination of the mind. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us become pure. This is Surah An-Nur. I said it yesterday, I repeat it today. When you have the modesty, the cleanliness, the chastity, the clarity of mind and soul and heart, you will achieve a nur on the day of judgment, a light that will be unmatched. May Allah grant that to us in this world as well as the next.